Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In this video, I'm going to talk about a very important enhancement that is coming up along with Winter 24 release, and it's called Selective Sandbox Access. I have a dedicated YouTube playlist where I am publishing contents about all the new enhancement, all the new features that are coming up with Winter 24 release. So if you haven't checked that out, please go and check that out. I'll put the link in the description as well as in the top right corner of this video. I spent quite a good amount of time preparing those videos, so I'll really appreciate if you like those videos. Please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel. Okay, so no more talking, let's understand what is this new feature all about. Before we start, let's understand the typical way how you create a sandbox. So this is your production org. You initiate a sandbox refresh, and what it will do, it will create a new sandbox. We all are familiar with this process. Now, when you do that, the person who actually initiate the sandbox refresh, that person will get access to this new sandbox, right? And his or her email address will remain the same. It will be the same password as the production password, and that person will get immediate access to this newly created sandbox or the refresh sandbox. What about the other people in the production org, all the active people from the production org? What will happen to them when the new sandbox will be created or the new sandbox will be refreshed? There will be an account for them in the sandbox, but the problem is that they will not be able to log in because their email address will be appended with .invalid. So if someone email address is abc@gmail.com in production, that person email address will be converted to abc@gmail.com.invalid in the sandbox. And then if that person needs to log in, the admin or the person who actually initiated the sandbox refresh, that person has to log into this newly created sandbox or the refresh sandbox, change the person's email address, remove the .invalid and reset the password. It's a very time consuming work, and we all feel the pain when we create the sandbox, right? We create the sandbox, we as a person who initiate the sandbox creation or the sandbox refresh, we get immediate access, but rest of the team members, they don't get access. They always reach out to us and ask, can you change my email address? I cannot log in. So as an admin or as a person who initiate the sandbox refresh, you need to go and change those person's email address, reset the password. So it's a big job. Taking action for each of the users, it is a very time consuming work. So what is the solution for that? How can we solve this problem? The solution is Selective Sandbox Access. So this is something that is coming up along with Winter 24 release, and I'm going to show you what is going to happen when this will be enabled in your production org. So as you can see in the screen, we create a sandbox refresh. It will refresh the sandbox, right? The person who initiate the sandbox refresh, that person email will remain same on the sandbox. As of now, it's the same process. Now, we want few users from the production org should have access to the sandbox. We don't want all the people from the production will have access to the sandbox. Let's say in production, we have 100 users. And out of those 100, we only want 10 users will have access to the sandbox. How can we do that? With Winter 24, you can do that. So what you need to do is basically, you need to create a public group. And inside that public group, add those 10 users to whom you want to give access to your sandbox. Add those 10 users to your public group. And then when the sandbox will be refreshed, those 10 users will automatically get access to your sandbox through the public group. And the beauty is that their email will remain the same. Their email will not be appended with .invalid. Their email will remain the same, like the person who initiated the refresh or the creation of the sandbox. What will happen to the rest 90 people in your org or rest of the people who are not part of the public group? They will still be there in the sandbox, but their account will be frozen. If you want one of them to get access as an admin, you need to go and unfrozen their user account and remove the invalid part from their email address and basically do everything to give them access. But the beauty here is that if you know in advance that out of this 100 people or out of the 1,000 people, only this many people I need access to my new sandbox, put them in a public group. And then whoever is inside that public group will automatically get access to the sandbox. And as an admin, you don't need to take any action. When I'm talking about taking action, basically you don't need to go and remove the invalid from their email address, reset their password and all these things. They will automatically get access to the newly created or newly refreshed sandbox. And it will be the same production password they can use on their sandbox. So this is a very helpful feature for the admin, and it will definitely help their day-to-day life. So let's understand when it's coming. So where this change applies to the sandbox of professional, enterprise, performance, unlimited, and database.com editions. So if your production org is of type this, then any sandbox created from that production org will have this feature. Now, when it's coming, this feature will be available in your production org when they will be upgraded to Winter 24 release, which is starting around mid of October 2023. When your production org will be upgraded to Winter 24, you will find this option available inside your production org when you create your sandbox. And who can use that feature? All users in the production org with the managed sandbox user permission. Now let's understand the advantages. The first advantage, it will restrict sandbox access to only authorized user during creation or refresh. It means you may have 1,000 or 10,000 users in your production org, but creating a sandbox doesn't mean that all users will get access to the sandbox. You have the power to select few users who should only have access to this new sandbox. Reduce the workload of manual email address update after refresh, since they will be part of the public group, so you don't need to do removal of their invalid from their email address. They will automatically get access to the sandbox and their email will remain the same. And the third point is safeguard data and configuration during development work inside sandbox. So if you are creating a particular sandbox or refreshing a sandbox for a particular project, then you can literally give only few users access to the sandbox. And that way you can safeguard data and configuration during the development so that no other team members will be able to go to the sandbox and play with the data or make some changes in the configuration. Your configuration will be locked to only the project team working on that particular project. Okay, let's understand how to enable this feature. It's very easy. You'll create a public group, add users into the public group whom you want to provide sandbox access. Third point is important because now, while sandbox creation or refresh, add that public group to the sandbox access user group. This is important. That way, only the users inside that group will get access to the sandbox, nobody else. As of today, my production org is still not upgraded to Winter 24, so I cannot create a demo. But my promise is that the moment my production org will be upgraded to Winter 24, I'll provide a demo and put the link of the demo in the description as well as in the top right corner of this video. So hopefully by the time you are watching this demo, my production org is upgraded to Winter 24 so that I can prepare the demo. And you get the link in the top right corner as well as in the description of this video. But till then, please hold on because I'm going to prepare the demo very soon. So if you think this feature is interesting and it's going to help your team, please share this video with your colleague, with your team, with your friends, so they know that there is a very interesting feature coming soon to their org. If you like this video, please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.